critical thinking is
lacking. Hey, speaking of critical thinking, you know who was a pretty incredible critical thinker?
Malcolm X.
No.
Malcolm X definitely was an incredible critical thinker. I was going to say
Bumpy Johnson.
Bumpy Johnson was definitely not an incredible critical thinker.
Hold on, time out. We are about to get into the Godfather of Harlem talk.
Sale.
Because the last episode aired Sunday, but we both just saw it tonight. So,
literally watched the shit while he was setting up. Yeah. I finished the episode. I was watching the shit while I was driving here.
100%.
Police cannot prove, so I don't have to worry about getting a ticket for.
I mean, just telling you, was glancing at it there now and again.
Still, you can't use cell phone.
I had it in my hands up display. Cool.
And I literally did. I had it in my hands-free display. I had the audio. So, yeah.
You was feeling that shit all the way.
This is like a drive-in theater that rolls with me.
Man, Joe. Hey, so Godfather of Harlem.
Hey, if you haven't watched Godfather of Harlem, you might as well go on here and check out now. Because we about to get into all the spoilers. And,
we're definitely gonna. I'm definitely gonna tell you how season one ends. I'm sorry.
This was the end of season one.
Yeah,
this was the last episode.
Yep.
Oh shit.
As far as I know, it was 10, right?
Yeah. This was episode 10. I don't know if the whole season is 10, but this was episode 10.
I think the whole first season is 10, and then they switch and then come back, and you know, boom, do another 15. But anyway. Godfather of Harlem.
Five, four, three, two, one. You deserve it now.
All right, go ahead. You got it because you got it. That is the Godfather of Harlem is the shit. I fuck Godfather of Harlem.
I don't know if it's the shit.
It's the shit.
It was good. I was entertained.
I fuck with it. I judge shows about how they make me react. When I react strongly to a character on a show doing something stupid, I think that means that I am invested in the show. I am invested in the show. I want to see who killed Bumpy, even though I also saw American Gangster. Spoiler alert. It's sad that I have to do that part. But anyway, Denzel played the nigga who was with Bumpy when Bumpy died. It was a department store they were heading out of.
Yeah, Frank Lucas.
And this motherfucker started coughing, and then he just was like, hey, yo, you the man now, and then killed over. Yeah. I don't know if the you the man part is true or not. I don't know. But, hey, it is what it is. It really doesn't even matter. The Godfather of Harlem television show on Epix is an amazing show. Mm. I like how they do shit on the show. I watched them motherfuckers call him a nigga 75,000 times to his face. And he just sat there and took it.
That doesn't make a great TV show.
It doesn't make an empowering TV show. It doesn't.
See, you were entertained with each and every nigga?
Right, but I wasn't empowered. And I wasn't entertained with each and every nigga. It was a couple of niggas. A couple of niggas that fit, a couple of niggas that did. You know what I mean? That just is what it is.
It's quite a few gratuitous niggas.
Yeah, it's definitely some gratuity of the nigger like word. Like motherfuckers is just be saying shit, just be saying it. But Godfather Harlem, I fuck with it. I just don't understand some of their historical references. Like the character that really threw me was Denzel. Malcolm X. His character threw me because he never wore a glove. One. Two. Mm-hmm. It was a little different in the way. Well, not necessarily different. It was more in depth in the way it went down, and for you to try to answer it in a bunch of little crappy
sad quotes.
I felt like
they made Malcolm a lot more subservient and fucking They made Malcolm X a bitch.
Malcolm X did look like the motherfucker that was standing in front of a motherfucking window with a whole AK, whatever the fuck he had, that, at the window, at the curtain, looking like, who the fuck finna try to get it?
They made Malcolm X look like a subservient bitch.
Malcolm X.
And I feel very disappointed in that fucking interpretation.
Definitely disappointed in that. Malcolm sat there and helped him, got duped by a street criminal into helping him clear out drug houses. So not that they could be clear of drugs, but clear of Italian motherfuckers selling drugs.
And full of black drugs. And he got duped by this same nigga multiple times.
Hey.
Multiple
times.
You wanna hit
the dumbest part? You're being duped to sell drugs. Well, Malcolm was being duped
to protect drug dealers.
To protect the drug dealer that was selling drugs for the very people that he was against that were oppressing him.
Yes.
You're working for your oppressor.
Yes.
And you seem to be okay with
that. And they made Malcolm X seem extremely cool with that shit.
He would have flipped out. I'm not finna use none of the brothers from the nation to
protect your fucking drug deals.
To participate in your right. I'm not gonna help you sell drugs to the very people in which I'm trying to save. That's what you're doing. You're selling dope to motherfuckers whose lives I'm trying to help get together.
Right.
As Malcolm would say.
Yeah. And it's just like the fucking horrible interpretation of fucking Malcolm was probably the biggest flaw I have in the show. Like, I mean, the show was pretty entertaining for the most part.
What did you think about the people that acted in the show, though? I liked Clinton Powell as Elijah Muhammad. I liked old boy from, what the fuck is he from? Damn, I can't remember.
Which one?
We were just talking about him. The kid.
The kid? The singer dude?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I like him. Well, no. We were talking about the singer dude. We were talking about... Anyway, it doesn't matter. I thought the show was well acted. I thought the show was well written. Even though I didn't agree with what you were writing, it made it come off in a real way. I could be upset that this happens. Like, I could be upset that Teddy got shot. Mm-hmm. I could be upset that they foreshadowed that entire incident happening the entire episode.
Oh, when the motherfucker was in the pool hall talking about, if I was you, I wouldn't have shot at myself. Show some initiative.
Initiative.
Yeah.
Yeah. They foreshadowed that dude dying. And I knew it was going to happen when he said that. I knew they was going to kill that motherfucker. Off.
I knew it was going to happen before. Because the scene before that, he was on a goddamn front porch talking about how he finna open up for Sam Cooke and then he finna move to L.A.
Oh, yeah.
Literally, you know right then. He was about to die.
Big giveaway.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you feel like the story was... I feel like my problem with the shit, my biggest problem with the shit... is how allegedly the whole entire 1960s revolves around fucking Bumpy Johnson.
Hey, Kennedy got shot?
Kennedy got shot.
Bumpy got
shot. Just so happened to know the motherfucker that know somebody that did that shit.
Bumpy gonna know something about it. Hey,
fucking Marshall Washington.
Bobby Kennedy get shot?
He just so happened to saw that shit coming because he knew that once Bobby Kennedy got killed, Then motherfuckers was gonna lose power.
Has anybody ever asked the question, where was Bumpy Johnson when Ronald Reagan got shot?
That's a great question. also, Bumpy might not have been there when Ronald Reagan got shot. However, to save this goddamn congressman, the very last episode.
Oh, that was dope. The one before the one you saw. That was dope when he slit that motherfucking cop neck, ear to like.
The nigga that was about to kill the congressman?
Yeah.
Yes.
No. Not him. There's a whole nother motherfucker. who does it, who acts in that particular realm. It's pretty great. It's pretty great.
All right, talking about the end. Was it the end? Yeah, it was the end. The end. Episode the 9. End.
Yeah.
When the nigga about to get out the car, and this motherfucker walks up and slits the motherfucker throat.
Yep.
Now.
What? You ain't fuck with that? You ain't fuck with that?
If you are the head, and I mean literally the head of an organization that is moving 10,000 keys of coke a month.
Right. It was a lot of motherfucking cocaine. I don't know how to quantify that shit. I don't do drugs. So I don't know what a lot of drugs is. And also, we operate on, we don't operate on the metric system.
Yeah. All right.
So I need pounds. To conceptualize it. You can't tell me there's a certain amount of this or that. I need pounds and ounces of shit. All
right. He basically runs, basically 5 times the Carter. Hey, before inflation.
Man, Joe, that motherfucker should never. And look, if he runs that, why in the fuck, when they got in the drought, was he so angry and so thirsty to start back up?
Basically, at the end of fucking season 9, when the motherfucker was like, hey, you know how many keys we get in a month? We're almost at 1,000. I said, was at $1,000. He's at 1,000 keys a month. My bad, not 2,000, 1,000 keys a month. Which breaks down to what, 3 keys a day? A key was technically 23 back then. So right. he was talking about buying it for 23. I said it's 69,000. How much did he money say? $5,000 a day. All right, so if he is doing $69,000 a day.
One day. Right.
And G Money was doing, in the car that was running, 5,000 in one day. So he's basically doing, we're going to roughly say 14 times as much before inflation.
Mm-hmm.
And still, he is the motherfucker that is walking up and killing somebody. He is doing the dirty work of motherfuckers who he would. Literally hire a motherfucker.
If you look at the last episode, he didn't kill nobody.
He killed a motherfucker in the second to last episode.
Last episode is what I said.
Last episode. No, he didn't kill nobody.
He don't kill no,
his daughter killed nobody. Somebody.
Yeah, well, she did, yeah. But it is what it is. Your daughter wouldn't kill for you?
Yeah, but if you are the leader of this fucking giant ass organization, you're not getting your hands dirty. You're not out there putting in work just for the cause.
It is a different time.
And also another thing that I had an issue with. Bumpa Johnson was what? 50, 55 years old?
When did that? Or during this
first season?
Because I don't have him at that age.
How old you got him?
Just not that age. I thought he was a little bit more spry.
You thought he was quite younger?
I thought he was in his 40s.
Yeah. With the Forrest Whitaker eye?
Yeah, I mean, Forrest Whitaker had that eye in Fast Times and Ridgemont High.
All right, so.
He's a teenager with that eye. Eye's never leaving. I don't give a fuck. How many times you smack her in the head, it's never going to move.
All right, so 40-year-old Pumpy.
Right.
Just got killed. Just got shot 4 episodes ago.
Okay.
Fights one-on-one with a hired fucking hitman.
Hey, look, I didn't get to witness none of that.
Huh?
I didn't get to witness none of that.
The last episode. The last episode when the motherfucker, damn it, when he sort of stabbed his daughter.
Oh, you talking about the What we just saw. I thought you were the one before that. Okay. All right. Cool. Yeah. You talking about what just happened in it?
The Kool-Aid pitcher.
I was trying to slow walk into that.
No,
I'm
getting to all of it.
You going right to it? Go ahead, dude.
Kool-Aid pitcher.
Yep.
The best hitman in Italy got his ass whooped by a 40 to 50 year old man who literally just got shot 2 weeks ago.
I honestly think he has a limp. I'm not sure, but Bumpy. Bumpy. I think Bumpy is kind of decrepit.
He's a cripple.
Not a cripple, but a functional, but like, yeah. Hey, yo, look. I can't move too fast.
He got a gimp.
Hey, yo, slow down. I'm done. No, stop walking. Oh, wait. Give me a second. Kind of cripple.
Yeah. It's there. So, yeah, I think, but according to this movie, he can go head up. When the assassin that got a drop on him.
Oh, yeah, definitely. But if you finna die, I'm definitely going to be able to tussle with you in my kitchen. I don't give a fuck how big you are. We're going to have that issue. My major issue was you motherfuckers shooting point-blank range at each other with Saturday Night Specials. And missing every shot you're going to take at him.
These trained assassins? These multiple murderers?
Well, let's be clear. Dude wasn't a trained assassin. Dude was a motherfucker that happened to live in Sicily that they knew who would also kill motherfuckers.
No, they said he was the number one assassin. Nigga had 40 closed contracts.
Yeah, they said that. All right. Still, it's a motherfucker there that has got to go to homeroom and speak the language to this motherfucker. Somebody got to tell this motherfucker that the La Policia look like this, they wear this, and sit here.
The nigga killed the policeman in 45 seconds.
Yeah?
And then get to the 45-year-old gimpy motherfucker, and all of a sudden, this got to be a long, drawn-out-ass fight?
Nah, I just thought it was a lot longer than what it was without the gimpy motherfuckers.
All right, Bumpy Johnson should have been dead.
Oh, 100 times over. His daughter should have stabbed his ass. Mm-hmm. But she loved her daddy, so you just got to line up.
All right, so do you recommend the show so far?
Oh, 100% I recommend the show. I enjoyed the show. The show, despite what we're saying about it, what I'm saying about it, despite that, the show itself is really fucking great. It just is. They're black superheroes, dude. Like, yeah. I like seeing that shit on TV.
You will love Hitman, but Watchmen. But we're speaking of Godfather of Harlem. All right, so if you, I recommend the show. The show is actually pretty good, but you have to watch this show in a very specific way. You have to watch the first four episodes. Three, you might be lucky and get through three, but maybe at the most you need to watch four episodes. And then once you get past episode four, you go back and watch episode one again, because it's going to take you four episodes of getting used to looking at Forrest Whitaker's fucking eye before you can actually watch the show and pretend that he's a normal person. And look, he has a normal face.
And look, I personally appreciate y'all rocking with it. Those that do rock with it. If you don't, you don't.
Forrest Whitaker's eye is fucking weird.
Regardless of Forrest Whitaker's eye, you don't have to get used to the eye.
You have to get used to the eye, because if not, then you're going to keep watching that motherfucker every time they show his face. And then you're going to be distracted and miss parts of the story that are actually really good.
By the time you sit down, visit your book bag 3, 4, 5, 7 times, by the time you sit down, get your popcorn and your wine ready, you're not going to notice Forrest Whitaker's eye. You're going to see that motherfucker as being low, and you're going to chalk it to Bumpy Johnson. I don't know what that motherfucker look like right now.
Hey, motherfucker, no. Do not drink and watch this goddamn show.
Do it.
I get drunk here watching. Like I get drunk every fucking Wednesday here. Sometimes I go home and watch the show. Hey, I watch this motherfucker. I go to 133rd Street while Bumpy Johnson was still on 125th having a goddamn speech, talking to Malcolm X. This nigga, I got up and walked off his goddamn face and went three blocks away. No, you do not want to watch this shit under any type of influence of drugs because you will pay far much too much attention to Forrest Whitaker's eye and it's going to take you out the whole goddamn thing. And it's like you just spent 40 minutes trying to figure out what the fuck he's looking at. And then you start imagining what the fuck is going on behind the camera that you can't see, that his eye can see.
I think if we warn individuals they shouldn't do that, then they won't do that.
No.
But some people are going to go to those concession stands, get their popcorn, and then go sit down and with their 3D glasses unnecessarily and watch this shit.
Nah, because it's like, you know, when you on a motherfucking bridge and you tell a motherfucker don't look down, what is literally the first thing they do?
You can't tell me not. There's a whole game based on not doing what like a finger is telling you to do. So I watched it and it's fun, but I think it's fun as a drinking game, but I don't often get to play drinking games with people because I just drink.
Yeah,
but
drinking is not a game. Drinking is life, bitch.
But what they do is, so you stand there, right? And so one motherfucker will move their hand, and they'll go up, down, left, and right, and they'll repeat it. And I don't know how many chances you get before you got to do the drink, but I know if you mess up what I'm telling you, what I'm pointing at. So, like, look at me. So if I do this. Your eyes went up, right?
Mm-hmm.
I do this. Mm-hmm. And then motherfuckers dance with it and be like, boom. But you can't look that way. Okay. You look that way, it's a drink.
So if I say up, and then a motherfucker look up, but my point that way, and they lose.
Up gets the drink. Makes you drink. You shouldn't move is the idea behind it. I believe. But I could be wrong, because they do weird stuff in schools nowadays, so it's different. But Godfather of Harlem, great show. You all should watch it. It's amazing. I had a great time watching it. Only thing I didn't like was that they showed Bumpy letting the Italian mob use him for the degradation of his own people. I caught that in the episode when he was talking to Bananio. He said, "My son's died. My son got murdered by black people. So now I just want to see them suffer."
Yeah, and this
and I'll also make money off of it, but fuck their lives.
Yeah, and these motherfuckers like, "Fru, fru, fru, fru. I still gonna please you, Miss Manson."
Bumpy was sitting there right along with hearing that and was complicit.
Mm-hmm.
I can't. It's hard for me to call him a hero, even though I like the show. I like the show for the show's sake. I like the show for what the show gives you. I like the soundtrack. I like the smartness of the characters. They still haven't done anything that was so out of a character, a natural character, that would preclude me from watching the rest of the show.
I don't know.
What?
Malcolm's timidness through all of this shit is pulling me out of it.
I think Malcolm was timid though.
Huh?
I think Malcolm was timid. In those situations, him talking to Elijah Muhammad, sitting there and speaking the way he speaks, trying to speak softly and diminutive and all that shit. I think it went.
His cowardness towards Bumpy Johnson.
I don't think it was a cowardness. I think it was
his gullibility.
It was his inability to fully understand what we're trying to get him to do.
I think he was gullible.
Yeah,
gullible. They're portraying Malcolm as gullible.
I don't think he was gullible. I think he was malleable. I think it was like, this is my man. I owe him one. He telling me this shit. He never steered me wrong before, so why would I think that he's doing it now? I'm going to go ahead and rock with whatever it is you trying to tell me to do. And he got both his sons in there. Well, one doing the video. The other one is the one that's doing the video composition. He's trying to make the Bubby Johnson life story in Hype Williams fashion. Yeah, that guy. Cool. Do it. Fine. I don't think it's 100% accurate, though.
Oh, no, there's no doubt.
It's just not 100% accurate at all. But, like, I don't think the accuracy of the story is the question.
Well, when you're telling something that's like a biographical film or series or whatever, mm-hmm. I think that it should have the semblance of truth in it.
That's why they always say based on a true story.
Well, yeah.
I mean, and that's just based in the general broadest sense of the word. Hey, Malcolm X knew Bumpy Johnson. Fuck it. This whole conversation based on the true story because they did know each other. Now, the fucking shit that they say, none of it can be true.
We have no clue, but we're going to make some shit up.
But hey, as long as it's based on the fact that they knew each other, then that's all that matters. We can say it's based on the true story. So I don't think like the accuracy of the shit, of the actual story is the problem. I think the portrayal of these characters as opposed to what we know about them is the issue.
I think we know enough about them to know that hey, some of this shit could happen. I think Malcolm could be duped by Bumpy Johnson if we're to believe that Bumpy Johnson was the Bumpy Johnson.
The criminal mastermind that they portray him to be, yes. In his first 10 episodes of the show.
Well, in just historical text also, I think that, yeah, I could dupe Malcolm X. I don't think Malcolm X is undupable. If I'm Bumpy Johnson.
All right, how many times you think you get up? You think Bumpy Johnson
not a lot.
Can get over Malcolm?
Not a lot. I think literally that one time when he was in the buildings and then they found out you own half of these motherfuckers. You own a portion of these shits.
Yeah, but even by that time, shit, that was already what, the second and third time that they done duped this nigga.
Yeah, but they just kept going on with it. The thing was that the way it was designed was the people that were being duped were supposed to be able to catch up to the people that were doing the duping.
And it
ain't gonna happen.
How often is Malcolm X gonna get duped by Bumpy Johnson? Because so the very first time is when the white motherfuckers was selling the dope in Harlem.
Right.
Very first couple episodes. And then we got when Bumpy Johnson's daughter was raped by the motherfucking security guards at the store. And Malcolm sent his people there.
Right.
And then we got the rent strike.
When they found out, Bumpy, you own part of these motherfucking shits.
Yeah. At the end of that. That was the third. And that's just what I can think of at this moment. You think Malcolm is falling for the same bullshit three times for the same motherfucker?
I don't think it was three times of falling for the same shit. I think it was one time falling for some shit, and then the other times he was actually like present in the class or sent over or whatever in interacting with these individuals. I think it was a different. I think you can be smart and dumb at the same time.
You think Malcolm was smart and dumb?
Yes.
I don't know about that. Not that Malcolm.
Malcolm, yeah. There's no way that Malcolm is Malcolm without being both smart and dumb.
No, there's no way Malcolm doesn't become Malcolm because of being smart and dumb. But after he becomes Malcolm, that motherfucker learns.
He learned some shit. And then he learned that everything I've learned was a lie. He said that.
He learned that.
I'm not talking about Godfather Harlem. I'm talking about an actual Malcolm Text. Mm-hmm. He learned that what I was like being told, everything about it wasn't truthful.
And what was that in regards to?
White people being a devil, being able to encapsulate. I can't, because I've been drinking all night. I can't remember.
But it's basically about the teachings of Nation of Islam.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. And then Malcolm was like, "Hey, yo, look, that shit cool, but it's not all like correct. Let me come in and correct." But during the correction process, individuals have issues.
Yeah, motherfuckers have issues, but I don't think that Malcolm X is the Malcolm X that we know is going to sit there and constantly be fucking out with it.
You keep saying constantly. It was like twice.
I mean, I just
one time wasn't even his fault. It just happened like that.
I mean, I just named three times during this show in the course of one season, which covered the course of what, maybe 4 or 5 months?
I don't know, because I binged a lot of this shit at the same time. Yeah. I don't know how long this shit's been on. I just know I saw all 10 episodes. Being the 10th being like right before we started this shit.
Yeah, but this shit is constantly happening on a consistent basis over a short period of time.
It happened maybe twice. Maybe. And then Malcolm was like, "Hey, yo, look, I see what you're doing. I'm not on that shit. Bump, you fucked up out here. You got to figure out on your own." And then Malcolm got gagged. That was like some real historical shit they placed in it.
A lot of this shit is real historical shit that they placed in it that didn't have ties to this nigga that they created ties to.
Because it was using cinematic license. And that's what it is. People take license. People take umbrance. You can't take nothing else from this podcast. People don't quit doing shit. They get fired.
Yeah.
Kamala was shown the door. Eddie was shown the door. These conspiracy theories on Facebook need to be shown the door. Godfather Harlem needs to be shown a second season. Cause that shit was entertaining the motherfucker, and I want to see how the rest of that shit shake out.
I mean, shit, they only are what, in 1963, so they got a couple more years.
He died in what, 68, 69, some shit like that?
I don't know. I know Malcolm X died in 65, so.
Oh, yeah, Malcolm X died in 65.
Still got another year and a half of Malcolm.
Regardless
of anything, we got a fucking Bumpy Johnson and Malcolm X buddy cop movie. They could do a whole second season of.
Oh, they're about to do it. They're about to do it. When they shook hands,
yeah.
They let you know season two is about to be about them, the Caped Crusaders.
Right.